As a result of this, it creates a struggle, it creates a crisis, it creates a problem. Now, talking of crisis, Sayyidina Hudhayfa, and of course very many other Sahaba as well, talk about how crisis or a struggle or a conflict or a state of devastation will affect you and I. And he gives some very, very beautiful advice. He says the following: as far as crises are concerned, in reality, it only affects those people that are weak. Crisis affects that individual that is weak. In other words, not a person necessarily that's physically weak, or a person that cannot bench 200 pounds, or for that matter, an individual that may not have the best vision. No, no, no. It affects that individual that does not subscribe himself or herself to the teachings of that which is pure and noble. When you relinquish that which is pure and noble, and you can examine this in yourself right now, where are you the most vulnerable, where are you the most weak, and you realize that the areas in which you are weak is generally as a result of your not subscribing to that which is pure and noble regarding that given matter. In other words, if you just reflected on your religion regarding that given matter that was of concern to you, you'll notice enormous amount of your ambivalence and ambiguity would have been eliminated. But because you took religion as a toy, you took your belief as a toy, you began to challenge your own belief system, you began to undergo at times a given conflict, and Sayyidina Hudhayfa says, if now you are suffering some weakness in that conflict, it is because of the fact that you were not able to ascribe to a higher level of existence. And thereafter he says, usually this individual is suffering from that disease where he or she cannot distinguish properly and appropriately between haqq and batil, between truth and falsehood. Now, my dear respected Muslim brothers in Islam, additionally we learn that the choice is not just to do good and bad. The choice is always to be able to distinguish between good and bad. And when you are able to distinguish between good and bad, you are able to make good choices, and you are able to reduce yourself from unwanted heartache and grief, unwanted blood pressure rising, and all those type of things. So therefore the ulama have stated, do the right thing from the get-go, and a lot of problems will come to an end. Nabi Karim sallallahu alayhi wa sallam thereafter says the following, and this is also found in Muslim Sharif as well. Safety of my ummah will come in my first generation. And after the first generation is concerned, you will begin to see reduced levels of safety, and it can be appropriately stated, satisfaction as well. Nabi Karim sallallahu alayhi wa sallam continues by saying, as far as the later generations are concerned, they will be affected with tremendous amount of calamities, grief, various types of trials and tribulations. The trials that will come, they'll be successive in nature. One will be worse than the next. In other words, each trial that you will see, it will be far more greater in comparison to the ones that have come prior to it. When the person is faced with that given trial and tribulation, the person will say, you know what, I am destroyed at this point in time. Again, let's take this hadith and compare it to the past 20 or 30 years, of maximum of the past 50 years. Think of the various events that have taken place? And the answer is quite obvious. Whether you look at parts of Africa and the various crimes that have been committed towards those people, prior to that, you go to the European experience of Bosnia, that issue was never mild at all. You go to the various parts of the Middle East, it has never gotten better at any point in time. In fact, it can be appropriately stated, things have gotten on the outside enormous amount of negotiation teams are moving around, but the issue and events of the last month will prove have gotten worse and worse and even worse. In each of the generation, each person will say, the events have gotten so bad that now we are destroyed. Nabi Karim sallallahu alaihi wasallam thereafter continues by saying, O you who believe, remember the following. Whoever wants to be safeguarded from tremendous amount of destruction, of course not only in this world, but primarily regarding the hereafter as well, and whoever is seeking the paradise, that individual must make choices that are so good in nature that if that individual's life is taken away at that point in time, whilst they are being challenged, they must rest assured that they must be able to pass the test of time by saying that if my life is taken, at least I will not be among those individuals that are destroyed. أَوَلَمَّا أَصَابَتْكُمْ مُصِيبَةٌ وَأَصَبْتُمْ مِثْلَيْهَا. Talking of this ayah, regarding that which afflicts us, that which we go through is nothing abnormal in comparison to those that have went through things before. The ayah says, قُلْ هُوَ مِنْ عِنْدِ أَنفُسِكُمْ. O you who believe, remember, whatever you are going through, whether it is social, economic, political in nature, the reason why we go through our challenge, it is because of things that we have done ourselves. In other words, the Quran is saying very, very clearly, whatever we go through is because of certain things we have done in life. And it is as a result of us doing certain things in life that we are now suffering its consequences, whatever this may be. And if you examine whether you are the victim or whether you are the perpetrator, there is something you are doing in a manner of imbalance. As a result of the imbalance, you will go through that which is proportional to it in nature. Therefore, my dear respected Muslim brothers in Islam, we have to begin to evaluate our religious choices as well as our social choices, so that way we can continue to eliminate the continual decline in ourselves and those out there. That is why the Quran says it very beautifully. Now we come to the primary ayah, وَاعْتَصِمُوا بِحَبْلِ اللَّهِ جَمِيعًا وَلَا تَفَرَّقُوا. O you who believe, hold steadfast. Not just hold steadfast, جَمِيعًا. Hold steadfast together as a body. Yes, you will have problems. You will have teething issues that will come into existence. That is normal. That will take place. However, you should never at any point in time say that because of this trivial difference, because of this trivial problems that are taking place, I have to now break away. I have to now do my own thing. As I tell people repeatedly, when people say prematurely, I want to do my own thing, I want to go away, when you must say them, go ahead, do that. Because you will realize that people of a common feather flock together. And you will notice one thing, people that want to break away on small things, let them gather together. I guarantee you, within 2 years, sometimes 2 weeks, if you're unlucky, but generally within 2 years or maximum within 5 years, you'll begin to see a split in that very group itself. This is a common problem I've seen on an institutional level repeatedly in various states.